One of the main challenges facing sanitation in Kampala is rapid population growth. Population growth rate of Kampala is estimated at 5.4% per annum, with the highest part of the population living in unplanned settlement called slums. Most of the population use on-site sanitation facilities like latrines and septic tanks, which require regular emptying. Only 8% of Kampala's population is connected to the sewer line. As a team of three sanitation engineers working at Water for People, we have developed a full suite of sanitation technologies, right from capture, emptying, transport, treatment, and reuse. Each technology is meant to respond to specific challenges. For capture, we have developed a latrine called a Jurasan, which is made of precast interlocking concrete blocks. It can be assembled within 4 hours to 2 days, depending on the number of stances. It is durable, easy to assemble, avoids overcharge and problems arising from poor workmanship of masons. It encourages emptying. It comes with different substructures which solve problems of high water table, collapsible soils, and rocky soil formations. The rammer has been developed to respond to challenges of dislodging pits in slums, which are normally inaccessible by vacuum tankers. The rammer is capable of pumping fixed sludge with little rubbish, goes deeper, and delivers sludge to receptacle in a sanitary manner. Transportation devices like a grappler, she lifter, hand cut, help to transport sludge from the pit side unit to the roadside unit, and also helps to lift heavy drums of sludge to the back of the pickup. A low-cost treatment plant has been developed using rotor mold plastic tanks. It's currently being scaled up in northern Uganda. It treats around 10 cubic meters of sludge per day. For reuse, we have developed a technology that converts dry fecal sludge into briquettes for cooking and heating. This is meant to replace charcoal from trees